श्रीमते लक्ष्मीनारायण परब्रह्मणे नमः। श्रीमते श्री हनुमत्समेत लक्ष्मणसमेत सीतायाः पतये नमः। श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। श्रीमते श्री अनंतगुरवे नमः। श्रीमते श्रीवेदान्तदेशिकाय नमः। अस्मद्गुरुपरम्परायै नमः। अखिलात्मगुणावासम् अज्ञानतिमिरापहम् आश्रितानां सुचरणं वन्दे अनन्तार्यदेशिकं श्रीमद्रामानुजाचार्यश्रीपादाम्भोरुहद्वयं सदुत्तमाङ्गसन्तार्यम् अनन्तार्यमहं भजे अनन्तार्यदेशिकम् अहं भजे। नमस्कारम्। We have been trying to enjoy the meanings of Sri Ramanuja Chatushloki composed by Sri Anantalvan or Anantan Pillai, the Acharya who was a disciple of Bhagavad Ramanuja and who chose to perform Kaikariyam at Tirumala by establishing and maintaining a flower garden and making it a point to offer the flowers of such a garden. Besides rendering this Kaikariya, Anantalvan has rendered some stotras as well, of which Sri Ramanuja Chatushloki is one. The Vishishtadvaita Vedanta or Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya is rooted in the Vedas. At the same time, it is rooted in the Pancharatra Agama also. The Vedas are called as Shrutis. There are four Vedas as we know. One may ask a question, if somebody masters all the four Vedas, is it possible for that person to get a clear picture of what the Vedas are trying to say? The answer would be a big no. Why? Because they seem to be different vakyas or statements in the Vedas which apparently seem to contradict each other. Some acharyas of other sampradaya, they have chosen to highlight a particular type of vakyas which either talk about Advaita or Dvaita. Sri Ramanujacharya, in line with his Purvacharyas, has very beautifully reconciled all the Shruti Vakyas by taking hints from the Shruti itself, duly supported by what are called as Smritis and Puranas. Sri Bhashyakara, as Ramanuja is hailed as, has composed 9 Granthas, of which Sri Bhashyam holds much significance. It is a commentary to the Brahma Sutras. The Brahma Sutras are part of the Prasthanatraya, the three most pramanas, important pramanas through which Vishishtadvaita Vedanta is established. The other two being the Upanishads and the Bhagavad Gita. Any philosophy must have a basis, must have a pramana. Bhashyakara, he chose to comment on the ब्रह्मसूत्रास एज पर हीज कमैंड. इट इज़ बेटर टू से ही ओबेड हिज गुरुज कमैंड्स टू राइट अ कमेंट्री कॉल्ड श्री भाष्य टू द ब्रह्मसूत्रास. In fact, it is Bhashyakara's own injunction to his shishyas that they have to study the Sri Bhashya. Why? Is it because he composed it and he wanted his shishyas to study it? No. Jnanan Mokshaha is a dictum. Jnanan Mokshaha means it is only through jnana we can secure liberation. Jnana about what? Jnana about Parabrahman. And that jnana has to be without any doubt or misconception. For which we need granthas like Shri Bhashya. It doesn't mean we can just take up the book and read by ourselves. No. We should study this text under an acharya. What happens when we commit ourselves to studying such a text? Our knowledge becomes very clear. There are several schools of thought apart from Vishishtadvaita Vedanta which try to confuse us, which try to bewilder us. If we turn to other mathas, their arguments would be so convincing. Even the arguments of Charvakas, the atheists, the material people, would be so convincing that if you go and sit there, perhaps you would say, yes, they are right. It is only the Shri Suktis, as we call the commentaries and the granthas composed by acharyas that stand as a fort to our own knowledge and guard our jnana from outside forces. Bhuvino vimatan tvadiya suktih kushili bhuya kudrishtibhi sametan शकली कुरुते विपश्चिदीद्या जय रामानुज शेष शैल शृंगे. द सेकेंड वर्स ऑफ श्री रामानुज चतुश्लोकी इज डेडिकेटेड टू द अर्चामूर्ति ऑफ रामानुज इन शेष शैल शृंगा आर त्रिमला. जय जय रामानुज शेष शैल शृंगे. रामानुज विक्टरी टू यू ऑलवेज. Bhuvi Naha. Bhuvi means on earth, here in Bhumandala. Naha means for us. Vimatan Tvadiya Suktihi. Vimatan means those who are called as Purva Pakshis. Those who do not follow our Sampradaya. In turn, by regarding or disregarding the Vedas, they come up with their own school of thought, which is not a proper interpretation of the Vedas if they adhere to the Vedas. So those are called as Vimataha or Vimatan. Kulishi Bhuya Kudushtibhis Sametan. Kulisha means the thunderbolt. Ramanuja's Shri Sukti is not an ordinary fire which destroys other schools of thought. It is instead the thunderbolt. We all know what happens when thunderbolt strikes. It annihilates. There is no scope of revival. Shakali kurute tears into pieces. Kudrishtibhi sametan vimatan. Kudrishti, drishti means sight. Kudrishti means improper sight. Some acharyas of other schools of thought, some gurus, they have tried to make sense of an incomplete portion of the Vedas. and project it as the meaning of the entire Vedas, which is wrong. Like we have the Purva Mimamsa school, which does not accept an Ishvara. They accept the ritual parts of the Vedas, but stop with that. They don't accept Brahman. They don't accept Sriman Narayana. They don't accept what we call as Moksha. And there are the Advaitins who claim that they are Vedantins, but they refuse to accept reality of the Jivatmas and Jagat. Though they accept Brahman is the only Satya. Then we have Sankhyas, Tarkikas, the Yoga School of Thought and so on. Then the Veda Bahyas, Buddhas, Jainas, etc. Who all come up with their own arguments. It is not only the ordinary people, but also to the scholars. Vipaschit idya. Vipaschit means a jnani. Tvadiya suktihi vipaschit idya. It is not. These texts are not for ordinary mortals alone, but even for vipaschitaha, even for the jnanis. With great compassion, acharyas compose these texts. Why? Because for generations to come, the shishyas need those texts to clarify, to understand our philosophy and to keep referring to it so that doubts and misconceptions are clarified. Akhila Bhuvana Janmasthema begins the Shri Bhashya. Such a beautiful text. Of course, not all are eligible to study the Shri Bhashya. Of incompetency, due to incompetency or due to other reasons. So Bhashyakara came up with two other texts, Vedanta Deepa and Vedanta Sara, all three being commentaries to the Brahma Sutras. Then Bhagavad Ramanuja has written a commentary to the Bhagavad Gita called as Gita Bhashya. Vedartha Sangraha is said to be the first Grantha composed by Bhashyakara. It's a very beautiful text which summarizes the import of the Vedic statements that are being usually misinterpreted or misrepresented. There is a criticism on Bhagavad Ramanuja that he has not composed commentaries, he has not commentated upon the principal Upanishads, the 10 Upanishads. Ishakena Kata Prashna Munda Mandu Keti 3, it goes on like this. Because Adi Shankaracharya, he has composed commentaries on the 10 Upanishads, thereby establishing Advaita Vedanta through his commentaries. But Bhashyakara, he did not commentate upon all the 10 Upanishads. Instead, he came up with a beautiful text called as Vedartha Sangraha, in which he ignores the straightforward statements and instead focuses only on those statements which are being misunderstood and misrepresented. Very beautifully, he refutes the other schools of thought like Advaita, Bheda, Veda, etc. and then establishes our own philosophy in a nice manner, in a beautiful language, citing Pramanas from Shruti, Smriti, etc. and Puranas. And then Bhashyakara gave us a text called as Nitya, which is like an Anhika Grantha. Anha means a day, Anhika means pertaining to a day. What should one Sri Vaishnava do in a day, on a daily basis? So it's Anhika Grantha, Nityam, it's called as Nityam. And then the three Gadhyas, श्री शरणागति गद्य, श्रीरंग गद्य एंड श्री वैकुंठ गद्य, इन विच द भक्ति ऑफ रामानुजा फ्लोस नेचुरली एंड फ्रीली एंड फाइंड्स शेप इन ब्यूटिफुल संस्कृतम. सो दीस आर द 9 ग्रंथास कंपोज्ड बाय श्री रामानुजा. Not all are argumentative texts, but some do engage upon other schools of thought like Shri Bhashya and Vedanta Sangraha and Gita Bhashya to some extent. Without these texts, the Guru Parampara after Bhagavad Ramanuja would have found it difficult to establish a school of thought, because in those days there were frequent debates in which an acharya had to participate and establish his school of thought. If he loses, he would have to convert himself to the other school, rival school. Like many acharyas have become Sri Vaishnavas from, let us say, Advaita school of thought, they have lost to our acharyas and they have converted to Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. So we owe a lot to Bhagavad Ramanuja for his contribution towards the wonderful texts. Anantarvan has very beautifully referred to those texts as like thunderbolts, idi as we say in Tamil, to destroy the rival schools of thought. Bhavino vimatan stvadiya suktihi कुलिशीभूय कुदृष्टिभिः समेतान् शकलीकुरुते विपश्चिदीड्य जय रामानुजशेषशैलशृङ्गे. श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः. श्रीमते अनन्ताचार्यगुरवे नमः.